Good morning, students. Today I am going to teach you 7th standard English unit 2 prose. The wind on Hunter Hill. Unit 2 prose. The wind on Hunter Hill. This lesson, this prose, The Wind on Hunter Hill, was written by Ruskin Bond. There are three sections. There are three sections in the prose. Now, I explain first section. Okay, Ruskin Bond, The Wind on Hunter Hill. Who is Ruskin Bond? Okay. Ruskin Bond was born on 19th May 1934. He was born on 19th May 1934. He is an award-winning Indian author of British descent. He is much renowned for his role in promoting children's literature in India. He got the Sahitya Academy Award in 1992 for Our Trees Still Grow in Dekra. He was awarded the Padma Shri in 1999 and Padma Bhushan in 2014. As a prolific writer, he has written over 500 short stories, essays and novels. His popular novel, Ruskin Bond's popular novel, The Blue Umbrella, was made into a Hindi film and was awarded the National Film Award for the best children's film in 2007. So his Ruskin Bond popular novel, The Blue Umbrella, was made into a Hindi film and was awarded the National Film Award for the best children's film in 2007. Okay, children, now let's see the prose. Section 1. The Wind on a Hunter Hill. What is this? It's a cried of wind. Cried the wind as it swept down from the Himalayan snows. It hurried over the hills and pauses and hummed and moaned in the tall pines and deodar. On Hunter Hill, there was little to stop the wind, only a few stunted trees and bushes and the ruins of what had once been a small settlement. There are three children stood beside a low stone wall, spreading cloths out to dry. See the picture? Three children stood beside a slow stone wall, spreading cloths out to dry. On each garment they placed a rock. Even then, the cloths fluttered like flags and pennants. Pusha, dark-haired and rose-checked, struggled with her grandfather's long blue shirt. She was 11 or 12. Her younger brother, Suresh, was doing his best to hold down a bedsheet, while Pinya, a slightly older girl, Pusha's friend and neighbor, was handing them the class one at a time. Once they were sure everything was on the wall, firmly held down by rocks, they climbed up on the dust flat stones and sat there for a while, in the wind and the sun, staring across the fields at the ruins and Hunter Hill. Usha must go to the bazaar today. She must go to the bazaar. Pinya wished that he could go with her, but he has to help with the cows and the housework. So he doesn't go. Their father was in the army, posted in a distant part of the country, and Suresh and his grandfather were the only men in the house. Suresh was 8, Chappi and Almond 5. Their grandfather says so many stories, especially horror stories, ghost stories. He says that many years ago, over 100 years ago, English people lived on the hill, but it was a bad spot. So grandfather says so many horror stories, now he says that many years ago, over 100 years ago, English people lived on the hill, but it was a bad spot, always getting struck by lightning, and they had to move to the next range and build another place. So because grandfather says during a terrible storm, one of the houses was hit by lightning and everyone, including the children. Okay, now Binya must go to the bazaar, so she got fear. Usha set out on her walk to the bazaar at 2 in the afternoon. It was about a horse walk. She went through the fields, now turning yellow with the flowering mustard, then along the saddle of the hill and up to the ruins. The path went straight through the ruins. Usha knew it well. She had often take it while going to the bazaar to do the weekly shopping, or to see her aunt who lived in the town. Wildflowers grew in the crumbling walls. A wild plump tree grew straight out of the floor of what had once been a large hall. So she was very afraid because her grandfather said story about the host, about ghost. So she was get fear to thinking about the ghost. The wind blew, the sound gives very loud sound. So she was very afraid when she was going to the bazaar. That's why Usha sang to herself as she tripped lightly along the path. Soon she had left during the ruins began. The path dipped steeply down to the wall and the little down with its straggling bazaar. Usha took her time in the bazaar. She bought soap and matches, spices and sugar, and a new pipe stem for the grandfather's hookah, and an exercise book for Suresh to do his sums in. So she bought everything in the bazaar. She had 2 rupees of her own saved up, and she used the money to buy herself a necklace of amber colored beads from an old Tibetan lady who sold stamps and trinkets from a tiny shop at the end of the bazaar. Usha met her aunt Lakshmi. She met her aunt Lakshmi, who took her home for tea. Usha spent an hour in Aunt Lakshmi's little flat above the shops, listening to her aunt talk about the ache in her left shoulder and the stiffness in her joints. She drank 2 cups of sweet hot tea. When she cooked out of the window, she saw that the dark clouds had gathered over the mountains. Usha ran to the cobblers and collected her mother's slippers. Then the shopping bag was full. She slung it over her shoulder and set out for the village. So students, the section 1, the wind on haunted hill, the wind on haunted hill, section 1 is over. I will explain section 2 in the next video. Thank you students, thank you for watching my video. Thank you.